Welcome back on Info for Triple E. Friends, from today, we are going to start a new series on MATLAB in which we will cover basics of MATLAB Simlink. This series is going to be very useful who are the beginner in MATLAB Simlink. So let me start the first lecture of this series. In this lecture, I will give you the introduction to MATLAB Simlink and its elements. Friends, my name is Ranjit Singh Jamwal, and in this series, I am using the practical approach to teach you the MATLAB Simlink basics. That means I am not going to cover the theoretical aspect of MATLAB Simlink. I will spend maximum of time on the practical work on MATLAB. Before starting practical session on MATLAB, I want to discuss basic element with you. MATLAB Simlink consists of two basic elements. First one is blank model file. It is a file on which you will create your simulation. Second one is library browser. Here library is a similar term as it is used in any college where books library consists of all the relevant books which are required by the system of college. Similar to that, library browser consists of all the basic building blocks which you are required to create the simulation. These two basic elements are going to be very useful while doing practical session on MATLAB. In our practical session, we will find the basic building blocks from library browser and we will drag it into blank model file. And this will be the basic steps we are going to perform in our MATLAB. First of all, open MATLAB. And after opening MATLAB, you can see that on the top middle of MATLAB, you are finding a link for Simlink. You need to click on it to open the MATLAB Simlink. After clicking on Simlink button, you will find that a new window will open with Simlink start page on which several options are there. You need to go on blank model section and click on it to open blank model file. After clicking on blank model file, a new window will open. This is the blank simulation file on which you are going to create your simulation. By default, it is named as untitled. If you want to change its name, you need to save it. To save this file, you need to click on save button. When you will click on it, a new window will open on which you can put your desired name, as this is the first lecture of second series of MATLAB. Therefore, I am naming it at mode 0201. Second one is save as type. So you need to select the Simlink model.mdl because the MATLAB simulation file have the .mdl extension. After changing both things, file name and save as type, you can save it. When you will click on save button, the name of simulation file will be changed with the desired name which you have written in the file. You can clearly see that the new name of the file has been assigned to this simulation. Now, second element of MATLAB Simlink is library browser. You can see that on the top middle of simulation file, here is a symbol of library browser. You need to click on it to open library browser. After clicking on library browser, new window will open, which is Simlink library browser. This library browser consists of number of toolboxes other than Simlink. In this series, I will focus to give you create the simulations using the building blocks available in under Simlink toolbox. This Simlink library consists of lots of toolboxes, but there are three most important toolboxes. First one is commonly used blocks, second one is sinks, and third one is sources. I am taking an example for any system. There are two most important things. First one is input, which you will get through sources. Second one is the output of any system. You need to watch it through sinks. Now friends, we are moving towards the conclusion of this session. What is required to create any simulation? We need to identify and select desired block, and we need to drag it into our blank simulation file. It is a basic step to create any simulation in MATLAB. It is all about this session. Friends, if you find this video useful, so like it and share it. If you want to get the notification about our future videos, so friends, so please subscribe the channel, and you can leave your query about this video in comment box. Thanks for watching Info4EEE.